Station on my side, okay. After the session, I will send it to you. Okay. Please turn off your mic, guys. If you have any queries, you can unmute. No problem. Even please turn off your mic. Okay. So start. Let's start our discussion here. So this is day one, 48 class. We already completed our basic stuff like what are the topics we can discuss in our complete training. So these are the modules which we can discuss in our complete training program. Now, let's start our first topic, which is called introduction and initial configuration. I told you guys introduction and initial configuration. Only this topic will take minimum 3 to 4 hours. Okay. So let's start our discussion. And let's start this discussion with 14 firewall day one slide. So guys, if I want to discuss about 14.8, so 14.8, what? 14.8 has 8 level of certification. Let's start some discussion on 14.8. So 14.8 has 8 level of certification. It's called NSC program, Network Security Expert Program. And you can see the certification here. You have NSC 1 to NSC 8. NSC 1 and NSC 2, these two certification are free, Ashok. You can go on 14.8's website and you can get certified. It's a free. Do you know about it? Do you have any idea?
No.
Okay, no problem. No problem. It's clear. So here, if you want to clear NSC 1, NSC 2 examination, it's a totally free of cost. Only what you need to do, you need to go on training.14.8.com. Okay, you can log out. Wait. Let me log out. Once you log in with this training.14.com, so you can get a login page. You can click on login here. If you don't have account, see right now, I'm trying to log in with public account. You can click here. If you don't have accounts, you need to click on sign up. You need to give all your detailed information, email ID, password, first name, last name, company, country. Then you can submit your information. Once you create your account, so now you can click on login and you can give your detailed information, your login name and your password. Is that clear, Ashok, Kiran? Now you can log in. You can click on login button. Now you can log in with this. Here we have option what? You can click on this option. And here you have what? Library tab. You can click on library. In library, you can get both option, NSC1 and NSC2. If you click on NSC1, so what option you can get? See, on NSC1, you can get information security awareness. This is the NSC1. You can click on this 33 place activities link. So now you are in NSC1 training, information security awareness. You can verify here. You have some videos, okay, on this website, predefined videos, okay, pre-recorded lectures, you can see. So lesson number one, lesson number two, lesson number three. Maximum you have what? 5 lessons here. So if you play this. Lesson number one, the topic is about bad actors. You can click on English version. You can play this video. The video duration is what? 5 minutes, 35 seconds. You can play this video. Once you watch this video, lesson number one, then you can go and attempt for your question. You can click on quiz. And here you can attempt your question. Okay, read your question very carefully. The question is from this video. So you have to watch this video very carefully. It will take 5 minutes. And what you can attempt your questions. You can attempt these questions, answer, click on next, then you can finish. So once you cleared your lesson number one, then you can go on lesson number two. In lesson number two, you can watch the video first. Okay, you need to watch the video first. Once you watch the video, now you can go for quizzes. So see, if you attempt all your lesson number five, all your lessons, so you can get a certificate from 14.8. Where you can get your certificate, you can click on here, dashboard and dashboard. You can go on profile. In profile, you can get your certificate. The certificate will look like this, like NSC1, NSC2. I can show you the option. The certificate will look like this. Understood my point, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Kashif, can you hear me, dear?
Yes, yes, I can hear you.
Okay, okay. I'm recording this session, okay? I will send it to you.
Thank you.
So this is NSC1, okay? Ashok, is that clear for you, Ashok?
Yeah, clear.
So like this, you can attempt for NSC2 also. So NSC2 certification is totally free. NSC1, NSC2. You can go on NSC2 and you can, this is the video, what evolution of cybersecurity. Self-paced videos you have. Same, lesson number one, lesson number two, you can see the module here. Okay, SaaS, cloud security, what is SD-WAN, a basic lecture you have, same. Just like if you click on firewall, so you can get a basic lecture here. Firewall lesson, you can get a proper video here. You can watch the video very carefully. Once you watch the video, you can get the basic information. It will hardly take 5 to 10 minutes, guys, okay? If you want to get certified, both NSC1 and NSC2, it will take 1 hour. But you know, if you talk about modules, so module is what? It will hardly take five minute module, like firewall, what, 6 minute video. You can play this video. Okay, so you can discuss about the firewall basics here, from here. So like this, you can certify it, guys. You can get certified NSC1 and NSC2. Is that clear now?
Yes.
It's a free certification. You can go on Fortinet website and you can get certified. Now here, what we have. So guys, I told you these are the NSC training. You have 8 level of certification, NSC 1 to NSC 8. And NSC 1 and NSC 2 is totally free. You can go on training.fortinet.com. You can get certificate. You can watch the video. You can attempt your questions. Now NSC 3 is for partners. So if you are Fortinet partners, you need to get certified in NSC 3. And your training is what? NSC 4. So we are learning what? NSC 4. So now we have NSC 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's up to you. You want to upgrade yourself, so you can go for NSC 5, 6, 7, 8. But right now, you are learning NSC 4. Okay, Kashif, is that clear? Now, as an administrator, if I want to purchase a firewall for my company, so what are the features I need to review? What are the features I need to review if I want to purchase a firewall for my company? So the first option is what? Architecture. I need to know the architecture of the firewall. Okay. Like this firewall, for this firewall, can install this firewall on my simple desktop computer? Like Checkpoint. In Checkpoint, we have a Gaia operating system. Gaia operating system, you can install on your desktop computer and you can use your PC as a firewall. Guys, do you have any idea about Gaia? Checkpoint?
No.
Do you have any idea about Checkpoint, guys?
No.
In Checkpoint, Kashif, we have an operating system, okay, Kiran? We have an operating system, it's called Gaia. Gaia operating system, just like a Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, it's an operating system. You can install your operating system on a normal desktop computer and your computer you can use as a complete Checkpoint firewall. But you know, so that is the use of Checkpoint firewall. We can purchase a hardware box, or we can use operating system, we can install operating system on normal PC. So the point is, you need to know the architecture, okay? If you are working with firewall, like Palo Alto is you working with SP3 architecture, single path parallel processing. So you need to know the architecture, means what? Can we install on a PC, or we need to purchase a dedicated appliance? Okay, can I purchase VM appliances in Fortinet? So I need to verify the architecture of the firewall. The second thing I need to review as an administrator, which is called session. So number of session it will support. So here we have an option, what? How many session it will support, so that I can purchase a model. A model like what? I have a series of, in Fortinet we have a series of firewall. So which series is suitable for my organization? So number of session it will support. Now VPN is what? Can I configure VPN like IPsec, remote access VPN, on this Fortinet firewall? So I need to review these kind of features, okay? Now integration, can I integrate my firewall with my Exchange server or with SharePoint collaboration server? Can I? So I need to know, all these options. Management is what? Can I manage this firewall through CLI or through GUI? Can I manage this firewall through SSH, Telnet or SNMP? Okay, if I'm working with multiple firewall, like 10 to 20 firewall, and if I want to manage all the firewall from centralized location, can I? So here we have option, need centralized management. Like guys, in Cisco, We have a next generation firewall, which is called Cisco Firepower Threat Defense. So to manage multiple Cisco FTD boxes, we required a single device FMC. In Palo Alto, to manage multiple Palo Alto firewall, we required a centralized box, which is called Panorama. In Fortinet, to manage multiple FortiGate firewall, okay, from a centralized location, we required FortiManager. So we have an option. So we need to centralize management for multiple firewall. Can I use this feature on this firewall? Okay, can I use failover concept, failover feature on this firewall? So I need to review all kind of features. Can I use these kind of features on this firewall if I want to purchase any firewall for my organization? Is that clear, Kashif, Ashok, Kiran?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
The point is here, what we have. See, if you decide for a firewall, so guys, we have what multiple vendor right now. FortiGate, Palo Alto, Cisco ASA, Checkpoint, Sonicwall. These are the vendors. Guys, you cannot say which one is best, okay? Because every firewall has its own feature. But these are the top best firewall. I can show you some picture, like the Sonicwall firewall will look like this. You can get this picture from Google, guys, okay? Sonicwall, it's a Sonicwall image. It's a Checkpoint firewall. This is a Palo Alto firewall. This is Cisco ASA firewall. And this is called what, Fortinet. So you can see the images of firewall. Now, if you want to discuss about some history about Fortinet. So Fortinet, it was founded in 2000 by two brothers, Ken and Michael. The company first product was FortiGate firewall, later adding wireless access points, sandboxing and messaging security. If you talk about products in Fortinet, so guys, these are the list of products, okay? Just like Cisco. Why Cisco is popular? Because Cisco has a complete solution for data center, for security, for routing, switching, for enterprises, right? For service provider. Same Fortinet is what? You can see all kinds of devices here. Like FortiGate firewall, FortiWiFi, FortiApp, FortiAnalyzer, FortiManager. Multiple boxes you have. These are the products in Fortinet. And now here, what our main focus to learn FortiGate firewall. How to work with FortiGate firewall. Now, let's discuss some default setting, you can say. So if I'm using a FortiGate firewall here, so what is the default factory setting? So if you are working with high or medium range of models, so you can get a dedicated management port, okay? Like on this, I have a firewall, FortiGate firewall. So I can get a dedicated management port. With this dedicated management port, what I can do, I can attach my management PC, and through this management PC, I can access this FortiGate firewall. I can manage through graphical, okay, with high or mid-range models. But if I have what, entry-level models, then in entry-level models, I need to use port number one as a management port. Means what? For example, if I on this firewall, I have multiple port number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want to use, for example, port number 1 as a management port. So yes, I can. If you want to use this port number 1 as a management port, so you need to enable these kind of services. Remember always, nothing services. No services are, you know, enabled on any interfaces. No, you have to enable. So like, for example, if I want to use port number 1 to act as a management port, so I need to enable ping, HTTP, HTTPS, and SSH protocol. Okay. And the default login is what? Default username to log in this FortiGate firewall is admin, and password is nothing. Okay. So let's try to access FortiGate firewall first. Okay. Let's do the basic stuff. So, guys, I'm using a topology here. In this topology, I'm using GNS3. On this GNS3, I'm using a FortiGate firewall. See, I have all kind of images, but our focus of this class is Fortinet. So I'm using a Fortinet firewall here. Now the cloud I have, the cloud is what? Cloud is my laptop. So I'm trying to connect my FortiGate firewall with this cloud, and cloud is my laptop. So I'm connecting this FortiGate firewall with this cloud. Let's start. So right now in this topology, I'm doing basic stuff. So what I'm doing, I'm configuring first port number 1. This is the port number 1, which I'm using. Guys, I'm working with entry level models. It means what? I don't have any management port right now. So I'm using port number 1 to act as a management port. Is that clear? Kashif, Kiran, Ashok?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Now, this is the console, guys. And guys, after this session, please everyone share with me your email ID so that I can share all the tools and software. Kashif, Kiran, Ashok, okay?
Yeah.
Guys, you can download. You can download it today. Please turn off your mic, guys. If you have any queries, you can unmute. So what we have, I can share with you all the slides, tools and software. And this Thursday, we can set up our lab, or this Monday, we can set up our lab. Okay, Ashok?
No.
So guys, please wait. It will take time to start, okay, this body. Please wait 2 minutes. Okay, can you hear me, everyone? So guys, this is what? This is a console. Kashif, it's a console. So I'm trying to access, it's a simple task. I'm using this FortiGate firewall, and with console port, I'm accessing this with PuTTY, okay? Now this console, what? You can see the username, login prompt. Username is what? Admin. Password is nothing. Okay, you can press enter. You can set your new password, 123123. Now you are in configuration mode. Now here you can type what? Show system interface. If you type show system interface, you can get the interfaces information. What? You have port number 1, port number 2, port number 3, port number 4, port number 5. Multiple ports you have, okay? Right now, as per my topology, I want to configure port number 1. So how to configure any interfaces in FortiGate firewall? The command is config system interface. Now you are in interface mode. So which interface you want to configure here? So you can type edit. Now type port. You can press tab here. So the port will change. Okay, see port number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now, for example, if I want to configure port number 1, so yes, I can type here edit port number 1. Now I'm in port number 1. So here I'm using a command set mode static. What I want to configure IP address statically. So the mode of this IP address configuration static. Now set IP address. So what IP address I want to configure? For example, I want to configure 192.168.255.187/24. Okay, now we need to allow some services here on this particular interface on port number 1. Set allows and what? You can see, you can type question mark here. You can get all the services information here. So for example, if I want to enable HTTP, HTTPS, ping, and SSH. And to save this configuration, guys, you need to type here end. Just like on Cisco, we have what? WR. In Palo Alto, we have commit. Here we have what? End. Now you can go, you can open any browser here. Before this, let me verify the connectivity. So you can see my LAN card information. On VMnet 8, I'm using 192.168.255. This series of IP address. That's why I'm using on my FortiGate firewall. That's why I'm using same series of IP address. I have 255.1. Here I'm using 255.187. Let's verify the connectivity. So I'm trying to ping from my cloud. So let's verify the connectivity ping 192.168.255.187. So yes, I'm getting reply here. And if I'm trying to ping from FortiGate firewall to my PC, so command is execute. And here you can type command. What command you want to execute? Ping. And what is the IP address? 192.168.255.1. See, you are getting reply here. You have a connectivity. Okay. Once you have a connectivity, so now you can open any browser. And here you can type what? 192.168. What? HTTP 192.168.255.187. The username is what? Admin. And the password is what? 123. I'm using it. So guys, you can see here what? This is your graphical page. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Kashif, Ashok, Kiran. This is the graphical page for FortiGate firewall. So guys, all the configuration we can do with graphical option. Kiran. So here what we have. If you see the information here on this graphical, you can get multiple tab here for configuration like dashboard, security fabric, network, system, policy and object, security profile, VPN, user authentication, login report. Multiple tab you have. Now, if you verify the dashboard information, in dashboard you have on status. If you click on status, you can get this information. This is the status. You can get this information in dashboard status option. Status is what? In status, we can get multiple information like system information. In system information, you can verify here what is the name of this FortiGate firewall, what is the CL number, what firmware you are using. So you are using 6.4.5. But the mode of this firewall is what? Guys, we can use our FortiGate firewall in two mode. First is called what? NAT, and second we have what? Transparent mode. I can show you the option. So the mode of operation. So we can use our FortiGate firewall in two mode. NAT mode means what? It's a L3 firewall. Transparent mode is what? It's called L2 firewall. So what we can do on NAT mode firewall? On NAT mode firewall, we need to configure IP address on interfaces. We need to configure firewall policy, VPN. Okay, all these kind of options. For transparent firewall, I told you we have a dedicated session on transparent firewall. But right now you see the default mode of this firewall is what? NAT. So right now this firewall is acting as a L3 firewall. System time, yes, you can get the system time information, uptime information. WAN IP address is unknown because we didn't configure anything. That's why WAN IP address is unknown. The license part is what? License is not highlighted because you don't have any license right now. Now, virtual machine, yes, you can get virtual machine information. You are using single CPU and right now you are utilizing 100%. You can also verify the information here, what? RAM. So right now you have 2 GB RAM and you are utilizing 50% of RAM. So now FortiCloud is not supported. Security fabric information, administrator information. Administrator means what? You can see one administrator is accessing through console and one administrator is accessing through HTTP. You can get all the administrator's information. See, the username is what? Admin. And the admin profile is what? Super_admin. What is admin profile? We have a module, no problem. But right now I'm only giving you idea right now. Administrators, what? One administrator is accessing through console. You can see the information. See, this is the console page. And one administrator is accessing through HTTP. This is your HTTP page. Username is what? Admin. Now guys, you can also verify the CPU utilization information. CPU utilization means what? See, CPU utilization, memory utilization, number of session information you can get here. If you click on this option, you can resize this page like CPU utilization you want to use, you want to pick, or you want to in two tab. So yes, you can. If you want to add more information, so you can click on add here. You can click on add. So for example, I want to add some other information on my dashboard, like SD-WAN, okay? Like HS status, failover. Okay. I want to verify the information about FortiView destination. Or let's add any botnet activity. You can click on close. See, you can see here what you have some extra tab now. HS status, SD-WAN. Can you hear me?
Yes,
Kashif, Ishu?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Now, what you have, you can now verify the rest information. See, on this side, on left-hand side, you have these options. Let's discuss these options now. So if you click on here, this is the search option. Search option you can use for example, if I want to configure network, any interface, for example. I want to configure interfaces. So you can click on network, you can go on interfaces, you can click on select any interface, you can click on edit. If I want to configure any firewall policy, you need to click on firewall policy and object, click on firewall policy, you can configure your firewall policy. The point is, if you know the tab information, where it is available, so you can directly go and click. But if you just forget the information, so you can click here and what, for example, you are in dashboard and what, if you want to verify the information, wait. Here I'm going to use, I want to search the information about interface. If you click the interfaces, wait. Interfaces, you can get all the tab information which is related with this interface keyword. So see, multiple information. If you click on network interface, you can directly go on network interface. So this search tab will help you to go directly in any tab. Now you can also discuss this option. If you click on CLI console, so yes, guys, we have two options. Either we can use this CLI or we can get one more CLI page on your graphical. See, if you click here CLI, see, same console, it is available on your graphical page. So if you want to work with consoles, you can work with here. See, show system interface, see? Same command, all the options you are using. So what, you can use your console from here also. If you want to use full screen, you can click here. This is the full screen mode. If you want to exit from full screen, you can exit. Now you can click on help. So here you have what, some help information. Like for example, I want to take online help coordinate. So I can select online help. It will automatically redirect it on your coordinate cookbook. See, coordinate library, you can say. Like for example, guys, I want to discuss about interface. What is interface setting? How to configure it? You can click on interface setting, and this is the information, tab information. You can see, for example, if I want to discuss how to configure VLAN. So this is the option, guys, like I want to configure any other thing like DNS configuration, static routing I want to configure on this FortiGate firewall, how to configure it. Yes, we have an option here. We can take an online help. You can also get video tutorial. You can go and verify your video tutorial information. Okay, a basic lab, you can see. Now you can go on your other option, release overview, you can get the information. If you want to verify the information about the license, so yes, right now we are working with VM firewall. We don't have license, okay? That's why the license will expire in 16.6. So you can get the license information from here. You can get the user account information. So which user is accessing? Admin, okay, admin. Now if you click on admin, you can get some other information here. You are using FortiGate firewall VM 64 KVM series, and the firmware you are using 6.4.5. And if you click on system, here is a tab for reboot and shutdown. So guys, if you want to restart and shut down this FortiGate firewall, you can. I'm not going to restart and shut down, okay, this firewall, because it will take time. So but here is a button, okay, if you want to restart and shut down, you can. Now if you click on configuration tab, so here is a tab for backup and restore. Backup and restore is very simple, okay? Like for example, if you want to take a backup, you can click on backup. Kashif, you have two options, local PC and USB. Right now, USB option is not highlighted. Why? Because we are working with virtual firewall. If you are working with physical box, so this option will be highlighted, okay? Kiran, Ashok, Kashif.
Yeah, got it.
Now, what we have, for backup option, we have an option for local PCs. Like for example, I want to store this backup on my local computer. So yes, I can. You can click on OK. This is your backup file, your default backup, default configuration. I have a backup. You can click on OK and see. This is your configuration backup information. It is in a plain text. So you can get all, you can see the all the information here. If you again click on here, backup, see here we have one more option, encryption. If you want to encrypt this backup file, so yes, you can enable this checkbox. You can set your password like 123. 123. So if anyone want to restore this backup file, it's required password. So what I'm using 123123. You can click on OK. Now this time, yes, you have a backup, but this backup is what? It is in a encrypted format. I can show you. See, the backup is in a encrypted format. Can you hear me? That is the thing, guys. So we can take our backup in two format. Either we can take a backup in plain text, normal plain text format, or we can take a backup as an encrypted backup. So no one can get what exactly in backup configuration file. Now we have, we can see the some information here, guys. In plain text backup, the first line, Kashif, is what? It is in plain text, right, Ashok?
Okay.
First line is what? It is in a plain text. Kiran, can you hear me, dear? The first line in this backup file is what? It is in a plain text. If you verify the information here, what? Here in encrypted, the first line is what? Let's say it is in a plain text. So remember always your first line always in a plain text, so that you can get the idea the backup is from which device. So what the device is what? Which OS version you are using? 6.4. So what the first line is, it will be in a plain text format, okay, in your encrypted backup. And yes, it's a plain text format first line in your simple clear text backup. Understood my point?
Yes.
For restore your configuration, guys, the task is very simple. You can click on configuration and restore. See, restore option. Only you need to upload your backup file. You can click on OK. That's it. Is that here? Kiran, Ashok, Kashyap?
Yeah.
Perfect. Let's discuss the another option in introduction and initial task. So what we have, guys, if you click on system, now I'm going to discuss our back option. 14.8 firewall. The topic is called our back. RBAC is called role-based access control. Role-based access control. What is role-based access control? For example, to manage this 48 firewall, I have a two administrator, for example. I have a two administrator. So wait. Administrator is what? User number one I'm creating and user number two. So these, they are what? They are the administrators. I want to give a privilege. So that's why I need to create admin profile. Admin profile. So what is admin profile? In admin profile, I can give the level of access. For example, I'm creating L3 admin profile. Just a name. In L3 admin profile, what I can do, I can give a privilege for full access. For full access, I can give a privilege, a permission to for full access. And this admin profile, I can attach with user number one. So whenever user number one will log in with 48 firewall, what he has L3 admin profile, full access. So he can do anything in your 48 firewall. But I can create one more admin profile, which is called L1 admin. And in this L1 admin, I can give a permission or privilege, you can say, for read only. So that what? I can attach this L1 admin profile with user number two. So whenever user number two will log in into 48 firewall, So what, he can only read the information. Understood my point? He cannot do any changes. That is called what? RBAC, role based access control. Is that clear my point? What is the topic?
Yes, sir.
I can create multiple administrators. I can define privileges to administrator. So here what we have, if you click on system, we have two tab, administrators and admin profile. If you click on administrator, so you can see guys, you have what, admin administrator, default user, admin administrators. And what is the profile here? This admin has super_admin profile by default. Now you can see, you can click on admin profile. So here in your FortiGate firewall, you have predefined two profile here. Admin profile. Two. What? Professional_admin and super_admin. So you have two predefined admin profile. The first is called professional_admin and second is called super_admin. What is the difference between both? Guys, if you click on super_admin, so what, you have an option for view. You can only view the information. You cannot edit anything. If you click on view, you can see security fabric, FortiView, user and devices, firewall, log and report, network, system, security profile, VPN, lots of options you have. And all the options are what? Read, write. It means what? Full access. If you click on return, and if you click on now professional_admin profile, so here you have what? Edit. So you can edit professional_admin profile as per your requirement. Like for example, I want to use as a read. So yes, I can use. But this is the what? Two default admin profile here in this FortiGate firewall. What is the difference between both? So difference is what? Let me show you the option. So what is the difference? The difference is what? See, if you have an administrator, for example, user number one, and if this user number one has admin profile, what? super_admin profile. If this user has what? A admin profile, super_admin. So he has what? Full global access. It means what? He can do anything. He can go anywhere in the firewall. He can do any changes. But here we have one more profile, predefined profile, which is called professional_admin. So what is the use of professional_admin profile here? See, if you talk about professional_admin, full access in virtual domain. What is this thing? See, for example, if we are working with multiple firewall, for example, guys, I told you, we can divide our single firewall box into multiple firewall box, right? We have a topic in FortiGate, which is called VDOM, right? We have a virtual domain topic where we can divide our single firewall box into multiple virtual firewall box, right? Yes or no? Guys, remember the topic?
Yes.
Let me show you. This topic, virtual domain. So what, we have a topic, VDOM. What is, see, so if, for example, if I'm dividing my firewall into three separate firewalls, so what, here we have what, for example, user number one, user number two, and user number three. So I'm creating three separate administrator for every firewall. What I am going to, I'm going to assign this user number one for this firewall, user number two for this, and user number three for this. Now, I can create user one, and this professional_admin profile, I can attach with this user number one. So whenever user number one will log in, he can only manage this marketing firewall only. He has full access, but in marketing firewall, he cannot do any changes in sales, in HR firewall. Understood my point? But if you have a user, for example, user number five, and user number five has what? If user number five has this super_admin profile, so what he can do, he can go anywhere Understood my point? You can do any changes. Is that clear? What is the difference between super underscore admin and professional underscore admin profile? Professional underscore admin administrator has full access, but within a virtual domain. Now you can go here. So you have two predefined admin profile here, but if I want to create my own custom profile, then I can use these profile, no problem. But if I want to create my own, so I can click on create new. Here I can define, I can give a name for this admin profile, like L3 admin. For L3 admin, I'm going to give full access, read, write for everything. Read, write, full access. You can click on OK. L3 admin. I'm creating one more admin profile, which is called L1 admin, just a name. And for everything, I'm going to give a read only permission. For everything, read only. You can click on OK. So now you have what? Two admin profile. L1 admin profile and L3 admin. Now you can click on administrators. If you click on administrators, so now you can create administrators from create new tab. You can click on create new administrators. And what here, from here, you can create your user account. Administrators, guys. So I'm creating user number one, for example. User one. And user number one is what? My local user. Password, I'm using, for example, 123. 123. And admin profile. So remember our L1 and L3 admin profile, guys. So I'm going to attach, I'm trying to attach this L3 admin profile with user number one. Here you have one more option, restrict logging to trusted host. Like if you want to allow only specific IP address can manage your FortiGate firewall. So yes, you can define here. Like what? For example, if I want to allow only 192.168.255.1/32 single IP address, or if I want to allow 192.168.255.150, only these two IP addresses can manage your FortiGate firewall. So yes, you can specify restrict login to trusted host. Right now I'm not using this option, but I'm only giving you idea. So now user number one and my admin profile, you can click on OK. I'm creating again one more administrator, user number five, for example. And what? 123 password, confirm 123. And administrator profile, I'm using L1 admin. Now you can click on OK. So now you have two administrators, right, guys? I'm trying to log out and log in with user number one. Password is 123. So user number one has L3 admin profile. It means what? He can do any changes. He can do anything in the firewall. Like for example, if you click on network, if you click on interfaces, if you select any interfaces, here is a tab, edit. You can click on edit. You can edit your interfaces. Now, if you click on firewall policy, if you want to configure any firewall policy, yes, you can click on create new. You can create your policy. The point is here, if I'm trying to log out and log in again, but with user number five. So what you can see, guys, you can see you have all the tab information. You have all the tab information and you can verify now. Wait, guys, you can verify now. You can click on network. You can click on interfaces. If you select any interfaces, for example, Ashok, see, you have a tab for view. See? You don't have any tab for edit. If you select port number 7, you can click on edit. You can only view the information. You cannot do any changes. If you click on system, if you click on administrators, see, you have a view option. You cannot create administrators. Is that clear? This lab, Ashok, Kashif, Kiran.
Yes.
Clear.
Yes, sir.
So this is what your basic thing. Okay. Now let's discuss the next topic. It's called interface configuration. Guys, let's start this interface configuration from tomorrow. Okay, everyone?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
So yes. Can I connect again on time at 6 p.m. IST time? Okay, everyone?
Yeah.
Bye-bye, guys. Take care. I will send this recording after 30 minutes or 1 hour. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, and please provide me your email ID, guys, so that I can share all the tools and software.
Already shared.
Okay, I already shared with you guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, I already shared in group.
Perfect. So you can download and we can set up our lab on Monday. Okay.
Yeah. Sure.
This week we can study Wednesday and Thursday, and Monday we can set up our lab.
Okay. I just shared the email address again if you want to.
Kashi, please send me in WhatsApp group. Okay. Or personal.
WhatsApp group. Okay. Yeah, in WhatsApp group. It's already there.
Okay. Bye bye everyone. Take care.
Bye. Take care.
Bye.